catching butterflies can be as simple as swiping them with your smartphone, at least in the world of augmented reality. This innovative concept was developed by Japan's Dentsu Media 4 years ago.
The iButterfly, as you can see now, it's an app, but it's very different in a way that it's a media platform in itself. So a lot of clients, just like they would purchase ads on print, outdoor, or TV, they actually treat iButterfly as a media platform.
You see all these beautiful butterflies flying around you. So once you see a butterfly that you like, you shake like that.
Using augmented reality, motion sensor, and GPS functions, the app allows users to catch butterflies and collect them to earn coupons. They can also be traded or exchanged for commercial gifts. As part of Dentsu's media agency network, Media Palette in 2010 entered Hong Kong's highly competitive advertising field.
In entering this market, obviously, in terms of volume, in terms of share, in terms of history, there is no way that we could be on par with any of our competitors. So I had to come up with something very strong and firm and iconic that will represent Media Palette. I saw iButterfly as a potential new business that could make us stand out from our competitors.
To do that, Media Palette enlisted the help of Hong Kong's mobile phone specialist, Cherry Picks.
We like it a lot. And when Dentsu Hong Kong came to us, Media Palette looked for a partner to develop iButterfly. This idea, we thought it was exactly what the consumer with a gamified experience is looking for. So we told Ken from Dentsu and say, well, look, if you ask me to develop iButterfly for you as a vendor, we're not interested. But if we can partner with you, because we believe and passionate about the iButterfly platform being a successful platform in the world, then we're interested.
iButterfly was rolled out in Hong Kong in May 2011 with campaigns by sportswear brand Adidas, Pacific Coffee, and bookstore Page One. 16 other brands to date have used the platform to promote their products or services.
Like those kind of apps only last on average, 30 days to 60 days. In Hong Kong, it has now lasted for more than 9 months. We still have a lot of new clients in the pipeline. Currently, we have 250,000 downloads, more than 7 million butterflies caught, which is more than the population of Hong Kong. So that already describes how popular the app is. Given the success in Hong Kong, once this is established as a business model in Hong Kong like we have here, it's just, you know, a waste to just keep it in Hong Kong. I want to share this so that all the other offices around Asia can also replicate and drive their own iButterfly. So we're currently rolling out in Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, soon in Taiwan, Korea, so all of these markets.
It's a joint creation, 100% developed and made by Hong Kong people with an original idea from Japan. Hong Kong take this idea and further it by wrapping a business model and all this together to make it commercially viable. Now it is a profitable business in Hong Kong, and the same business model and the technical platform is exportable to other countries in Asia and going home back to Japan. So I think this is a very good way to show and perhaps to demonstrate the dynamics and the success of this kind of partnerships.